Okay, guys, I'm gonna go through a quick, and I'm gonna demonstrate if you're interested in toning up your thighs or maybe around the bottom area, the glute area. I'm gonna go through three of the main exercises from my experience and my experience of training women. I'm gonna go through three of the main exercises on what you need to be doing. So Jan is gonna help us out with this. So thank you, Jan. So the first movements that we're gonna do is we're gonna do a leg press exercise. So here we have two variations. Okay, this one, the weight, when you're sitting, when you get yourself in position, the weight's more vertical, so the weight is gonna be almost right above you, which is gonna feel a bit more difficult than it is with this leg press machine here, because the weight, as you're pushing away from the plate, it's more horizontal. Some people, this is probably a safer machine. So some people may feel safer in this kind of exercise. And also the weight is more supported on a belt, whereas there's no support on this machine here. Okay, so when we're doing these leg workouts, we'll vary between this machine here and this machine here. We do this exercise first, or if it was a full leg workout, we'd add in thigh extensions and leg curls and a couple of other things. But as I say, because we're only demonstrating two or three of the main exercises on what you need to be doing to work thighs and bottom, we're not going to include them. So Jan is going to just do a quick demonstration of using this machine here. So we've set the weight. The weight's on your light. It's a 20 kilogram plate inside. The feet will start off at the bottom, so that'll give you leverage to push the plate up. So the feet are at the bottom. You'll push the plate up. When you've done that, you'll put your feet in position there. So there'll be feet shoulder width apart high, because we're going to push through the heels and not the toes. If you push through the heels, the pressure goes through the thighs and to the bottom. If you push through the toes, the stress will go right through the knee. So Jan will just demonstrate this movement here. Okay, push it now. So you're going to breathe in on the way down, breathe out on the way up. 90 degrees at the knee joint is sufficient for me. Get the knees in line with the heels, pushing through the toes, pushing through the heels, sorry. Everything stays in line. Sometimes what can happen when you do this movement is the knees will come in like that, okay? If that happens, then maybe drop the weight or put a ball between the knees, as I say, to keep everything in line. If the knees are coming in, and then again, the stress is coming away from the thighs and bottom and going through the knee area. Okay, that'll do, Jan. So when you take it back, you walk your feet down, that'll move up the plate, and you're able then to bring in those support poles there and put the weight back. Very good, Jan, very good. So that's that leg press. Then we'll try and use that mostly than this one. Some people feel more comfortable on this machine here. So Jan will jump in to this. Okay, we keep the seat on the first notch there. So the back straight. We'll set the weight so it's not too heavy for the first set. And then we'll get the chair close to the plate. And you'll start off with the feet at the bottom. You'll now push yourself away. You'll now put the feet higher. Okay, feet shoulder apart. Breathe in. Moving that way, breathe out. Push through the heels again. Everything will stay in line. Not too fast. Okay. Sometimes, when I'm teaching someone, I'll teach them to extend so the legs are locked out straight there, so they have a little bit of a rest. Or sometimes I'll tell them to come up about there, so the legs are just slightly bent at the knee area, and it keeps the stress on the thighs and the bottom. Judaism. Okay, we'll take that back now. So when you're finished, or when your client is finished, you let the weight start, you'll release the chair, you'll come up, and I'll lock that in. So we'll tend to do those two moves. Before we do a squat or a lunge movement, we'll tend to use those two exercises. Increasing blood flow around the knee, around the hip area, and preparing them for the bigger movements, which is going to be squats and lunges. So Jan will just demonstrate the squats now. And just take this down. Oh, you're up. So, what some people may do is they like to put this on the bar. Okay. Personally, I don't like to use this when we're doing squats. Okay. What this will do is it'll make the bar feel a bit more comfortable across your back or your shoulders. The downside of using this is that people tend to have the bar in the wrong position. Okay. If you're not using this, at first, if you're just a beginner with squats, using the bar, you're probably gonna feel a little bit uncomfortable with doing a squat with the bar across your shoulders. But over time, the bar will fall into a position what you're comfortable with, okay? So I don't really like to use this or suggest to people that they use it, but if people want to use it, then I'm fine with that. Jan wants to use it. That's okay, not a problem. So, see, the bar is right across the shoulders there. If that's not there, what some people will do is they'll have the bar on the neck. They won't feel that because they've got this sponge on the bar, okay? But I want people to have it across the shoulders. So you'll take the weight. So your head's up, your stomach's in, tight, your chest is up. You'll take your feet shoulder-width apart. There, okay? So you're breathing lower. Whoa, whoa, squat, 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 squat. So breathing lower, breathe out, push up, okay? So the first couple of repetitions, carry on. We're aiming for 90 degrees at the knee joint. Some people who say they like to go deeper on a squat. For me, this is enough. If you do want a deeper movement, we'll use that. Or you can go deeper when you're doing lunges. Okay. But for a squat, aiming for 90 degrees is enough. If you go past 90 degrees, you might be more inclined to take your chest forward, so therefore stress will go onto the lower back. But really, we want to try and keep it on thighs and bottom. So when you come all the way up to squat, when you come all the way up, you'll squeeze your bottom for a split second, and then you go back down, okay? I like to teach it feet position. I like to teach it with feet shoulder apart. Some people don't feel comfortable with that, and I'll put the toes slightly 10 to 2. Again, I like to just one more jump. When I come up, if it's a heavy weight, I like to straighten out the legs and rest here. What some people will do, just squat again, is come up, not all the way up, come up, one more, and then go back down. So, like the leg press, sometimes we'll have the knees soft, and it's a bit of a quicker movement, so the stress stays on thighs and bottom, rather than resting it at the top and you straighten out your legs. Okay, Jan, super, so that'll do. You walk it back in, stay tall. Now, Rob, just walk it back, right in. So rather than turning your head and seeing where the bar's going, if you're using a frame like this, just walk right into it. When you hear a bang, you'll know that you've met the frame, okay? If you turn and look at where the bar's going, more inclined to have an injury. The final exercise, so we've done a leg press to warm up the thighs, the knees, the hip area. The two main exercises then are squats and lunges. just use the bar. And Jan will demonstrate this exercise. So, sometimes what we would do is we would start off using dumbbells and you'll just do single leg lunge, okay? And as people get more advanced, they'll do an alternate lunge then, which is then going to challenge your balance. When we put the weight, when we use a bar, it's harder again. So with us, we've got dumbbells. The dumbbells are here. We've now got the weight across the shoulders, so it's above, almost above us. So it becomes a bit more difficult. So Jan, just do a single leg lunge. Step bent, step back. Both knees have to be 90 degrees. So no, just stay on my leg. Stay on my leg. So as I say, for a beginner, we might just do a single leg movement as clients or whoever is building up the strength and the balance for this exercise. When you can do that, so we'll just focus on the single leg. When you can do that, then we'll do alternate lunges. So we'll do left leg, right leg, squeeze your bottom at the top, both knees 90 degrees, push through the heel. Remember, any squat or pressing movement, you push through the heel to help with the thighs and the bottom. If you're pushing through the toes, the stress is going to go through the knee. So keep the core tight, the chest up, the shoulder back. Also, as you're doing this, your heart rate's going to go up as well, okay? For me, lunges are a brilliant exercise. I've always done them in my own leg workouts. I've always, since I've been doing personal training, I've always taught lunges. Okay, John. I've always taught lunges. Great exercise. From a bodybuilder point of view, it'll help cause separation from your thigh and your bottom, if that makes sense. Great. It's a great exercise. So, there's three exercises. If you're looking to tone up your thighs over the next few weeks or next few months, or you want to tone up your bottom, they are three of the main exercises that you need to be doing, okay? We'll use the leg press to prepare your legs for the bigger movements, which are going to be squats and lunges, okay? So, hope those tips help, guys. Thanks to Jan, who's gone. Help us with that video. Well done, Jan. And thanks to Jess, who's been filming the video as well. Cheers, guys. Thanks.